So basically it draws in the energy. If you put it in a place that has very bad energy, you will actually see a blackness in the sky that converges over the cloudbuster, and that can take for 1 or 2 days, and then you will see the nature of the sky change. You will see a new sparkling energy. It's visible. It's visible. So the next one is these cones that Don Croft called the holy hand grenade. It's not referring to anything very violent. It's actually a Monty Python thing. That is an orgonite cone that has a crystal pointing upwards and 4 crystals pointing outwards at the bottom. It draws energy in from the top and then distributes it laterally. And finally, so we can make them in pyramid shape, we can make them in conic shape. And then finally, we've got tools that are very cheap and easy to make, like this one that we call a Tower Buster. Tower Buster is called Tower Buster because it was invented to neutralize the negative energies from cell phone towers, mobile phone towers. But we actually use it as a very universal tool. We put them into large water bodies because water is distributing energy wide and far. And they come in different shapes and sizes. We make very rough ones for outside, and we make some slightly nicer ones for inside the house. And another important one is the earth pipe, where you have a hollow pipe that is filled with this orgonite mix by about 1/3, and it has a crystal pointing downwards, and that one we use to hammer it into the ground for any negative energies that come from underground. You can use your own fantasy what that could be, but this is something that everybody can do. This is how we make Tower Busters. You get a simple muffin form. You put a small bedding of aluminium filings. You put a few crystals. They can be fragments. They don't have to be beautiful. So, you know, as you get like crystals by the kilo, you use the nice ones for the more sophisticated tools, and you use the breakage for the Tower Busters, so you can use them all.
From Brazil?
Hmm?
Brazil
is beautiful.
No, no, do you get the crystal from Brazil?
No, we try to get them from Africa. But now the Chinese are buying all the crystals, you know, so it's becoming more and more difficult. So also the prices are going up. So then we put additional things in there. We like to put pyrite, and we like to put amethyst. It doesn't have to be the super quality stuff. I mean, it doesn't have to be the optical jewelry grade stuff. It can be ordinary. And then we mix the resin and we pour it in. And then we wait 30 minutes and take them out, and that's it. This is how you make one of these. That's how we used to make them, because now we have nicer molds, but you can use a simple household funnel and close the outflow. At that point I was using window putty to make that plug, and then you put the crystal that is supposed to stick in the top, you embed it in a bit of filings, and then you fill it like half, and you put the 4 crystals that are pointing outwards, and then you embed it in more filings, and I'm almost finished, yes. And there is how you make a cloud buster. African activists based in Kenya have adopted the orgonite and started to make it into a viable business. They go to farmers, small African farmers, who are very happy with the results, also fishermen, because they find the fish become more abundant, the crops are growing a lot better, but they haven't stopped by this agricultural, but the agricultural application is their business, that's what finances them. But they've also gone into the conflict zones of southern Somalia, South Sudan and eastern Congo, and observed the pacifying effect of orgonite. This is very difficult to prove, you know, but we observe it again and again that there is a consciousness effect of massive deployment of orgonite in a conflict zone So here you can see the effect of orgonite on cell phone towers. We believe that microwave radiation is weather modifying. The jury is still out whether they do it deliberately or whether it's a side effect. I personally believe that there is a secret agenda connecting all these towers to a more sinister purpose. But be that as it may, that is not important for our discussion here. You can see this area of towers before and after. You see the sky is rippled like a herringbone pattern. Here it's already forming beautiful cumulus clouds. And you can see a vortex forming, you can see a blue hole emerging. These two photos on the bottom, I have to apologize for the bad quality, they show the same site, basically 20 minutes apart. So that's a very typical experience that we have had thousands of times. You can see immediate effects of orgonite on a sky. The sky, I believe, was fully chemtrailed. It had like a level of chemtrails on top and other cloud underneath. You can see an energy flare here shooting up in total silence, by the way. These occurrences are not accompanied by wind. It's a purely energetic phenomenon. You can see here, that was in Uganda in 2004. On this mountain, which was in a closed-off military area, there were several towers on top, and we didn't have a chance to go very close. The only thing we did was to place two of these about 2 kilometers, and the effect was that. And this is not a tornado, this is not a hurricane, this is a silent energy vortex that came about in total serene silence.